This is the Randy B with Tristate Indie. I'm sitting here with House of Song and members of House of Song and Good Star Records artist. We have Nathan Zub here and Mark Dignam and Ben Shannon. And what caught my interest about these guys, besides the great show that House of Song's put on at Marion Courtroom last night, was that they are out of Pittsburgh. They have a collective and a label. So they're doing it themselves, and a group of musicians coming together, working together, booking shows, playing shows together, and you know, really a nice synergy going on. So part of the thing that's great about indie music is when bands do that. So Mark, why don't you tell me a little bit about what you guys do?
In terms of the label?
Yes. Or have the label come about and that stuff.
Well, I mean, we've been all very big fans of each other's music for the last number of years.
Uh-huh.
And we just kept meeting for coffee, kept meeting for drinks, and then basically talking about how tough it is to go it alone in the business, particularly these days. So we just figured, well, let's share the resources, share the costs, and try and see if we can make a dent as a collective label.
Okay. Now, do you each, obviously, so it's you guys. I know last night I saw a great set by Morgan Arena, who's in Broken Fences. They'll be doing a showcase later. Was there any kind of, like, divvying up, hey, this guy's going to do the distribution, here's the recording studio? I mean, how did that work?
Yeah, we're looking at that at the moment. We're pretty fledgling, but, you know, what we've got is the collective spirit right now, and then we're going to start sharing out jobs. It's coming about organically. I mean, I'm doing a bit of booking, Ben's doing a bit of booking. We've got somebody who helps us with promotion, and he's turning into the studio guy, so we're getting a lot of his input on that. So it's almost like it's less about divvying it up and everybody falling into the positions that they're really good at.
Right.
We're very lucky with that.
So a natural kind of thing,
yeah.
Not really like a delegation of different responsibilities.
Yeah.
Nathan, why don't you tell me, or Zub as you're called, how did House of Song come together? How did you and Mark get together?
Yeah, I was an intern at a studio out of Pittsburgh called Tree Lady. And I was probably the worst intern. I was in the running for the worst intern that they've had. And but I had met Mark there. He was working at the studio. And we started jamming together, and I think just the rest is history. We just started playing together.
So how long has House of Song been together?
Well, I've been on the go for a lot of years, but this particular band has probably come about in about the last year. And what I'll actually say about how Zoo came on, it's not quite that way. I went to see a show with a band he was doing, and I wasn't that crazy on the band, but I kept looking to the guitar player at the side.
I agree. I was looking at him last night too,
yeah,
man. Where's that sound coming from?
Kept getting my attention, so I just asked him to come and play.
Great. And Ben, how did you come on board with these wild men?
Mark heard my song. There's a really great open mic songwriter night in Pittsburgh every Monday night called Acoustic Cafe at Club Cafe. And a lot of people get through there, and he heard a song of mine, and we sort of got together, and he introduced me to some people at Tree Lady, and I ended up cutting my album there.
Tree Lady's another studio out there?
Tree Lady is a studio that we're all affiliated with. And that, you know, they put out, they're more notable for their mastering on a national level, but they really have an incredible room, incredible gear, and we're really happy with what we put out through them.
So, am I to envision, like, you know, there's open mic night, you guys are getting together, you're seeing each other, you're doing shows together. So it's really a very family kind of oriented thing.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, we clear our schedule for each other's shows, and we promote the heck out of our shows. We also try to help other artists coming out who we believe in, and I think it's about the songs being high quality, and the delivery, you know.
Right. So, how has the experience of the conference been so far? Is this your first time to Lancaster? I mean, what are you thinking about this whole launch thing?
I think it's a lovely town. I think it's an absolutely lovely town. And a lot of the artists that we've seen have been really exciting. It's been grueling. It's been tough. We woke up really early to get here, and, you know, we were up all day and running around and playing
driving
shows
across,
and things like that.
The
driving across,
right?
Yeah.
So nice. So what plans in the future are, I think, going on for the label and for you guys individually and the bands and stuff?
I think right now Ben's album, Move On, is the first thing to come out on the label.
Uh-huh.
Pretty close behind that will be the Broken Fences release, and then the House of Song release will follow on from that. And then we'll just keep tumbling through records. And I mean, our big thing about coming here is kind of, you know, expanding out and meeting more and more people in the business, you know, people like yourself, you know, who we can talk to and not have to go, leave me alone.
Right, right. Well, you haven't known me that long, but you may get that way. Another few minutes, it may
10 minutes, we see how it goes. But, you know, we're basically, like everybody else, we're not really sure that we're out there looking for record deals right now because of the way the industry is. So we're taking it as far as we can possibly take it ourselves and branching out and meeting as many people as we can and seeing where that all takes us. And if the right person walks up with a distribution outlet or licensing deals and all that, very happy to talk about it. But we're trying to see how far we can push it ourselves.
Excellent. Well, I appreciate spending time. I enjoy the rest of your time in Lancaster. Wish you great luck. Hope to see you passing through here on a tour.
Thank you.
This is the Randy Beach with Tri-State Indie, and we've been speaking to members of Good Star Records, Nathan and Mark and Ben. And, you know, check out Broken Fences if you're around.
Absolutely.
And
Absolutely.
Just, do you guys have a website that people can just listen to all the music?
We're putting that together at the moment.
Okay, to be revealed and announced later on. But again, thanks for your time.
Thank you so much, Randy.
Thanks a lot.
And I appreciate you sitting down with me. Take care.
Yeah.